Welcome to Modular Classroom. Today, in this video, we will see how to take a screenshot in Windows 10. That is why we are familiar by taking screenshot while using our Android smartphones, but while we are using our desktop or laptop with the Windows version, that is 10 version, how can we take the screenshot in any particular content from the window? That is, it may be in either Word or PowerPoint or a Chrome browser or a PDF file. It may be anything. How can we take the screenshot? Let's look at this video and we will get into. For that, we need an application that is built-in predefined application in Windows called Snip and Sketch. Snip and Sketch application offers several options for how to snip, that is how to take screenshot on Windows. First of all, you have to decide whether you have to take the screenshot at the second or after a delay of 3 or 10 seconds. Then you can decide which type of snip to take, rectangular, free from Windows or full screen, anything. So before entering in it, let's go to your search bar here and type Snip and Sketch. You can able to get in to this predefined or pre-installed application on Windows. This is the environment of this. So as the text displays, press Windows logo key plus Shift plus S. This is the shortcut to snip what is looking into the screen without getting into this application. That is the shortcut to take the screenshot. If you press this shortcut, again the control will take you to this application only. So after going into this application, just click this new snip, control plus N, that is new snip. Now you can select the option, that is directly you can say to take the screenshot now or after 3 seconds or after 10 seconds. And next option is, after clicking this, now I am clicking the snip now, I am opening a PDF file. I want to take this particular diagram or particular figure in this slide. So what I'm doing is, after opening this PPT, I'm clicking the Snip Now option. See, the particular now the screen somewhat looks dim, and this toolbar appears over here. That is, it consists of various options like a rectangular snip or a free from snip or a window snip or full screen snip. I'm just clicking this rectangular snip. See, the plus mark symbol appears like this, and I'm just clicking and dragging. And when I release the mouse button, this screenshot appears in this application, the Snip and Sketch application. This particular image, it is a screenshot, appears in this application. And this Windows 10 offers very additional updated features, like you can able to annotate the image that you have taken. See, this is a ballpoint pen, and this is the pencil, and this is a highlighter, eraser, and a ruler, and crop. Various annotating options are available for the screenshot that you have taken. Once you have pressed this ballpoint pen, you can just choose the color, any color, and you can just underline like this, or you can highlight the image what you want to decide. And by using the highlighter, you can say something important point is this, like that you can able to underline. And if you just by mistake you have done any annotation wrong, you can just use this eraser button to erase the annotation. And you can use this ruler option so that you can see your annotation or is done correctly or not. If you want to do some underlining option, that is also available here. By using this ruler, you can give an underline. And crop function, it allows you to adjust the image that has been taken into the screenshot. Like this, you can crop and you just click the tick mark, so this will be applied. Now this is the image. Now finally, you can save this particular image, or you can copy and paste into another tool, or you can share with external devices. I'm clicking the save button. It will ask me the location where to save that image. I can give anywhere. I can rename the file also, and I can click the save button. This image will be saved. Or if I copy this image and again I'm going to this PowerPoint, and here after inserting a new slide, if I want to paste this particular image with the annotation. See, this is the original image that I have annotated from the screenshot, and I'm pasting it again in this tool. Likewise, I can able to reuse this screenshot image after annotating with this Snippet Sketch tool, and I can again reuse in that particular application. And I also can able to share externally with the inbuilt mail or OneNote or anything. And again, this Snippet Sketch does not allow only to taken the image, it has been as a screenshot and annotate. Whatever the image, you can open the file and you can annotate that image also. For example, I am just opening one image, and here if I need, I can able to annotate. I can use this pointer like this and all. I can able to, any image I can able to annotate with the help of this Snippet Sketch. This is one of the advantage. You no need to install any extra third-party applications. You just use a predefined application called the Snippet Sketch to take the screenshot in Windows. It may be you can take a screenshot from a PDF or Word or a PowerPoint, anything, and you can able to annotate the image. So thanks for watching. Stay tuned.